Hi, my name is Adam, and today I will guide you through the most important step you should take after signing up for Elastic Email. That's the verification of your domain. Why is it so crucial? First of all, a verified domain can significantly improve the deliverability of your emails. Those emails are seen as more legitimate and are less likely to be flagged as spam. Secondly, it helps build a positive sender reputation. It also builds trust and credibility. Recipients are more likely to open emails from a validated sender. Furthermore, a fully verified domain permits you to use any from address linked to it when signing your emails, enabling you to achieve complete branding of your emails with your domain. Equally important is the matter of authentication. Protocols such as SPF or DKIM are pivotal in thwarting email spoofing and phishing attempts, guaranteeing that emails genuinely originate from your domain. Last but not least, you can access more accurate email analytics and tracking data with verified domains, so it's definitely worth the effort. We strongly advise against relying on Gmail, Yahoo, or any other publicly available free domains as your primary domain, as this can negatively impact your email delivery rates. Utilizing your own domain significantly enhances the likelihood of your emails reaching the recipient's inbox. So now that you know why it's worth verifying your domain, let me show you where to start. You can verify your domain in the settings area. There are two different ways to do it. The more effortless but a bit more limited option is to verify your email. It doesn't require access to your domain provider and is extremely quick. You just need to click Verify Email, type in your email address, and check your inbox. After clicking on the link you receive in the email, you should log into Elastic Email again, and your sender email should be verified. However, it's important to note that this approach has limitations. You can send a campaign from this domain, but exclusively using the particular verified email address. For example, if you verified campaign at mydomain.com, you can't use marketing at mydomain.com or sender at mydomain.com if you didn't verify those specific email addresses beforehand. With domain verification, you'll get more advanced features. By selecting this option, you can utilize all email addresses associated with your domain. On this modal, click on Verify Domain, and you will be presented with a step-by-step guide on how to do it. In this video, we will show you every stage of the domain verification process. In this case, we will use GoDaddy, but that process would be similar for every domain provider. For proper configuration, you need to include three distinct records in your DNS zone. Let's start with Sender Policy Framework, also known as SPF. To add this record, log into your domain provider and reach the DNS zone. You will possibly find many records that have already been added. There are two options. The SPF record has already been created, or you will have to add a new one. It's essential to note that each domain can possess only a single SPF record, so you won't be able to add another one. You should modify the existing one, if it exists. As you can see, an SPF record has already been created, so we just need to edit it. In the value section, we need to add this additional variable. This is what it should look like at the end. However, there's also a chance that an SPF record hasn't been established yet, as is the case here, and we'll need to create a new one. Here's how you should do it. Let's choose a new TXT record and fill in the host and value. The host area depends on the domain provider. You might have to leave it empty, fill it with an @, or just type in your domain name. In the case of GoDaddy, you should use an @. Once that's done, you just have to copy and paste the value in line with our guide. And there it is. The SPF record has been created correctly. SPF is obligatory to verify your domain, but we strongly recommend adding DKIM and tracking records. For each of these, you'll need to generate additional TXT and CNAME records. Let's copy the name and value and paste it into both areas, name/host and value. And that's it. Now let's check if everything works correctly. It's essential to keep in mind that it could take up to 48 hours to propagate DNS properly, so don't worry if everything does not work immediately and you see this screen. It might require some time before your domain will be validated, but within 48 hours, you should verify the record and see this screen. That means that everything is set and your domain is ready to be used. Now it's time to set the default sender. That will determine which email address will be added to your new campaigns by default. This is our way of saving you time, so you won't have to set this up manually every time you send something. Finally, we've got it all done. Congratulations. Your domain has been verified, and now you can fully brand your emails. The final email address is up to you and your goal. Only your domain can limit you now. If you prefer articles instead of videos, there are some great text guides in the description of this video. If you spot any problems during the verification process, please contact our support team. Our experienced specialists will get you through the entire process in no time.